I mean, it was pretty good. It was a bit of a busy day, I think. I don't think I've seen it so busy in a little while. But it was pretty good having a look around. I think the majority of the time that I've been there before is because they have an art museum on. Because I think this is the first time that I got to see the entirety of the history side of the museum. Because I went to see the Picasso prints that he did. I enjoy it when they have little costume corners. It's great to be able to involve people in the history sort of tactilely. Things that they can touch, things that they can play around with. Obviously, I really like some of the Godiva stuff. I think it ties neatly, because there's signs of it everywhere, if that makes sense, especially if you're new to Coventry. And I think being able to explore that, or maybe having someone explain to you why all of these like little disparate elements from Coventry that maybe you didn't think were connected are all actually just part of this larger story is pretty interesting. Do you hear the motto, sort of peace and reconciliation, a lot when you talk about Coventry? And learning about the history behind this and ongoing efforts behind this sentiment, I think is very important even today, just simply because there will be no shortage of troubles for people ahead. I don't foresee a time where war doesn't happen, and I think looking into Coventry's history with the devastation in people's lives and how they've sort of dealt with that and how they've built a community of repair around that on both sides of a major world conflict, I think that's really important to learn about and to try and apply to our modern life at the moment. Especially as a student, if you've come to a new place, learning about its history and expanding its horizons is important for your development and your learning. I mean, it applies to everything. It's part of one of the great things about multiculturalism is being able to travel to a new place and to learn.